Hey there, and welcome to Breakfast with Mark Daniels from Monday, May 4th, 2020. Hard to believe we're already into May. Our standard greeting of saying, "Hi, how are you?" has now become, "Hi, I hope you and your family are well and safe." And I hope that's true. Luckily for my family, everybody is healthy. I mean, psychologically, we're all going a little nuts, but with the nice weather, at least we've been able to enjoy some more time outdoors. And I hope you do the same. It's amazing what 15 minutes, a half hour, maybe 1 or 2 hours outside can really help clear your head. There's something I wanted to cover in this week's episode that's happened to me a couple of times since the pandemic began, and that's scams. Scams are everywhere, more scams now than ever before. One of which was a job application that I found on a very reputable site. It wasn't the site's fault, but somebody had posted a job and with a very reputable international company, and I applied for it. I was given a link to fill out a job application form, and in doing so, as I started to anyway, I realized they were asking for a lot of personal information, and I haven't even made contact with anybody at the company. You know, they wanted your driver's license, a picture of it, they wanted your passport, they wanted your social security number, date of birth, yada, yada, yada. I mean, I quickly caught myself before I filled out anything important, but it just goes to show you that people will do anything to take advantage of a bad situation and people who might be desperate to find employment, unemployment, stimulus checks. The bottom line is, don't give out any personal information because there are a lot of these scams out there. I mean, basically, these scammers are taking advantage of people who are in desperate situations. So just be aware of who you're giving information to. Make sure it's an official site. And also be aware it may look really official when it's not. So just raise your guard a little higher these days. And one more final point about scams. I've gotten a couple of them in my email. Some of them look really official, and some of them border on threatening. Just be really careful with whom you respond via email. Make sure it's people that you know or a company that you absolutely know, because they're out there and they want your money. So last week, we, of course, received the official word from the governor that school would be closed for the rest of the academic season. I mean, we all pretty much knew that that was going to be the reality, but it was always a matter of hoping, especially for the seniors, to be able to finish out their 4 years of high school in the school. But when you actually heard the announcement, that's when reality really sunk in. I mean, I'll be honest with you, it wasn't a great day for my daughter, who was looking forward to her prom and graduation and yearbook signing and all the festivities that come with being a senior and leaving high school and moving on to college. School officials assured the kids and the parents that they're working on some sort of a plan to make sure that the kids get their rite of passage and are celebrated like every other class has been celebrated in high school. How that will come to be? Well, all I can tell you is that I would not want to be a school official planning something in this unknown environment. So I give them a lot of credit for trying to keep the kids' spirits up and assuring them that they'll be celebrated. And I trust that they will be. And the electronic sign in front of the school said, "Class of 2020, we celebrate you. Stay positive." So here's to all of the graduating seniors. You did it. Maybe not exactly the way you planned it, but you still did it. And we do celebrate you. Some colleges are not having graduations. Some are doing it virtually. My son's graduation is this Friday, and we're going to be able to watch it as a family while they call the names, and I assume the valedictorian will speak, and that'll be it. His diploma should be in the mail in a couple of days. Somehow, they have planned an in-person graduation ceremony for early August. We'll see if that comes to fruition. If not, they still promised, like the high school, to do something in person for the graduates at some point in the future. And speaking of education, my wife and I had this conversation just the other day. Some schools have said that they do plan to open in the fall and that there's a really good chance that all college courses, at least for the fall, for some schools, not all, will be online. I mean, if you think about it, how do you socially distance an entire college campus? That's why most college campuses close so early. And let's just assume that College X, whatever it is, has announced that they're fall classes will be online, at least for part of the fall semester, if not all of the fall semester. What do you do, especially when you have a new freshman entering the system? Do you pay all that tuition for your child to learn at home? I mean, a college education, that tuition portion of it anyway, is about academics and about the experience, the social interaction, the social learning as well. So it almost seems like if you're going to pay all that tuition, you're missing 50, 60, 70% of the college experience. Do you have your college freshmen start their higher learning education from their bedroom with a laptop? Or do you tell them to take off a semester or maybe even a year until life gets back to sort of what it was? I assume there are risks involved, including maybe losing your grant or your scholarship. But it is something that we're thinking about. We're not quite sure what we're going to do when we have to cross that bridge. I mean, college is really expensive, as everybody knows. I don't know. Maybe if they put that tuition on sale, maybe it might be more attractive, especially for people who have to start their college learning online. I mean, the airlines aren't getting much business these days for obvious reasons. And there are $29 fares from Long Island MacArthur Airport to Florida. Maybe it's time that the colleges rethink their tuition structure in order to attract kids to keep their education going when they wouldn't necessarily be able to be there in person. I don't know. I'm just thinking off the top of my head. And on another note, it's the behaviors that we learned as kids and young adults and adults, things that we've done for many, many years, have changed so much since COVID-19. And we still find ourselves sometimes slipping back into those behaviors and then catching ourselves and realizing, oh, no, can't do that anymore. Quick example of this was I was working in the yard the other day and the UPS truck showed up to my house. And I don't know, I thought I'd save the guy a couple of steps. Not that my front door is very far from the street, but I figured, you know, UPS workers are walking all day. So I walked toward the guy and I'm thinking to myself, I'll just take it from him and he'll hand it to me. And as I'm walking toward him, I realize, A, I didn't have a mask on. He didn't have a mask on. I didn't have any gloves on. I mean, I was working in the yard. We both kind of stopped and I wasn't sure whether to say, just drop it right there or what. It was just a really awkward situation because, you know, I knew if he handed me this package, I'm not going to be 6 feet away from him. You know, my arms don't reach that far and neither do his. So we both walked toward each other, looking at each other, awkward. I extended my arm as far as I could extend my arm out. He extended his arm as far as he could extend his arm. And he handed me the package and I thanked him and I, you know, wished him a good day. But it was a very awkward situation because normally, you know, you walk up to somebody, you take something from them, and then you go on, you know, on with your business. But this way, I realized I'm not supposed to do that. And the other quick thing that happened yesterday, we did a socially distant get-together with some friends and neighbors. And, you know, everybody brought their own lawn chair and their own snacks, and we hung out, you know, at least 6, 9 feet apart. But the thing was, I hadn't seen some of these people in a long time, especially my friend Joanne. So, you know, Joanne came late, and as she, you know, she came to our little gathering, and right away I got up and I wanted to give her a hug, and I got up and I thought I can't sorry Joanne, I can't hug you, but it's good to see you. I haven't seen you in a couple of months, and normally I would, you know, give her a hug, like, you know, shaking hands with, you know, my friend Scott. But it's just so interesting how, you know, your brain reacts to doing things the way you used to do them socially, and now you have to kind of rewire yourself not to do it. And finally today, what we've been doing on the last couple of episodes of Breakfast with Mark Daniels, offering a song that offers some hope, some brightness. This has always been a favorite of mine, and it's always made me feel good, and I hope it does the same for you.
Darling, it's been a long, cold, lonely winter.
And that'll do it for this episode of Breakfast with Mark Daniels. Please stay well and stay positive. And I'll see you next time for Breakfast with Mark Daniels.